Hi guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I hope you guys have checked out our previous video on MS in Artificial Intelligence, Machine Learning and Robotics, where we discussed the various universities that you can apply to. Today, we're going to be discussing yet another very, very hot and trending topic among our MS aspirants, the Management Information Systems and Business Analytics. Starting today's video to understand what exactly is MIS and what exactly is business analytics, what are the job profiles that you can expect after graduating from these courses, what are the top universities in USA offering these courses, and the most important of all, we're going to be reviewing two profiles of students who've got admits and how did they go about getting these admits from top universities for these courses. And as always, we're going to be giving you exciting giveaways throughout the video to help you get the best admit for your profile. So stay tuned till the end of the video for these surprises. Let's get down to business. What exactly is MIS and what exactly is business analytics? A master's in management information system enables you to use computer-aided technology in business functions. You would be part of creating a data warehouse that will aid efficient business operations. And integrated systems like this can do wonders for any given organization in terms of key functionalities like increasing the revenue of an organization or increasing the profits of an organization or even increasing the output of the employees and sometimes even decreasing the production costs. Now let's look at a use case example of such integrated information systems. Now suppose an organization wants to find out what kind of customers come for repurchase, there needs to be a proper knowledge transfer set up between the sales unit, the marketing unit, and of course, the production unit. Now, that's where MIS will come in handy. So if you are a techie looking to expand your breadth of knowledge in the information technology side of affairs, then MIS is a perfect fit for you. Business analytics, on the other hand, is the use of tools and techniques to derive meaningful business insights from any given data. It trains individuals to develop their data quality sense, understanding of any given business model, and most importantly, data-driven decision-making capabilities. As a business analyst, you would be very instrumental in providing solutions to complex business problems. Now, let's take an example. I'm pretty sure most of you would have gone for various e-commerce websites, right? Now, if the e-commerce websites are smart people, then they would hire a business analyst team to get insights of how purchase happens. Now, say for example, this team might come up with an insight that 60% of customers who buy product A also buy product M. Now, the business decision here to be taken is if product A is placed right next to product M, they can increase the 60% to say 85%, which might directly increase in their revenue as well. So if you see yourself in a very strategic position in your organization who's responsible of taking important business decisions, then a degree in business analytics can definitely accelerate your career forward. Now that we have clarity on what exactly MIS and business analytics is, let's dive into understand what are the job opportunities in this market. Now, if you look at the popular job roles that students graduating from MIS take up, would be network and computer system administrator, computer and information research scientist, and computer system analyst. The best part about graduating from MIS is that the starting salary for an MIS graduate could range anywhere between $71,500 to $81,528, and this is just the beginning. The US Bureau of Labor Statistics places the median salary of computer and information systems managers at $139,200, and the job prospects couldn't look more promising. Between 2016 to 2026, in the US alone, job growth is pegged at 12% for computer science and information system managers, which is faster than average and expected to open 44,200 new jobs over this period. Now, coming to business analytics, which personally is my favorite, the kind of job profiles that you can expect are business analyst, market research analyst, statistician, management analyst, financial analyst, big data analyst, and data science. Now, median pay for business analyst is about $82,450, and within the next 10 years, the projected growth is 14%, which translates to 115,000 more job opportunities. Pretty neat, huh? Now, a couple of more questions that students have asked me in discussions about business analytics is that, what kind of median salary is paid for each of these roles? And what are the states in US that hires these graduates? And one more very popular question is the difference between data science and business analytics. To address all these questions, we have compiled an ebook which is available in the link of the description. Do ensure you check it out if you have these questions. So now that we've understood what exactly MIS and what exactly business analytics is, and the fact that we've covered the job opportunities, the next important segment is to understand the top universities that you should be looking into if you plan to join this course for your master's. Starting from the top, we have so many universities like Carnegie Mellon University, Texas A&M University, University of Texas Dallas, University of Cincinnati, University of Southern California, and a lot more. To make this job a lot more easier for you, we have compiled the set of universities, the GRE score requirements as a separate ebook, which is available in the link in the description. Do ensure you download the same. Do keep in mind, these universities expect you to have a very good GRE quant score, and your TOEFL score needs to be 90 and above, and most importantly, work experience is usually recommended for departments like MIS and Business Analytics. Since the demand for universities like this have increased, so has the competition on a global scale. To ensure you have an edge over the competition, let's have a sneak peek into the profiles of students who've got admits in these departments. The first profile we have in hand is Shivani Sharma, a fellow student from GREH. She joined us with having 2 years of relevant work experience as a mainframe application developer at Cognizant Technology Solutions. She gained the working knowledge of very important programming languages such as COBOL, SQL, PL1, REX, and JCL. This experience exposed her to real-world scenarios where she used her expertise to provide business solutions. Now, sheer mentioning this in her statement of purpose strengthened her application, which helped her get an admit from Texas A&M University, one of the best universities for this field. The next profile we have in hand is Archit Satra, a student from GREH who all through his academic life has shown excellence and enthusiasm in programming languages, as is evident from his GPA. This in turn helped him great deal in his professional life as well. Archit also had relevant work experience in the healthcare industry, where his job was to deliver meaningful insights to the organization. He was trained in data warehousing tools and also proficient in languages like SQL, PLSQL, C++, and BlueJ. He too had an LOR from his client manager, whom he directly reported to, which really tied his profile together to make it one of his best analytics program in US. Keep in mind, both of these profiles have work experience and is in fact recommended for programs like MIS and Business Analytics. Each aspect of your application process, like your GRE, your TOEFL, your IELTS, work experience, your statement of purpose, decides what kind of universities you need to shortlist. And to make that job easier for you, we have a special giveaway that explains a unique strategy to arrive at the best possible admits for your profile. Grab your copy from the link provided in the description. There you go, guys. These are some of the most important questions I'm pretty sure you had when you came for this video. If in case I've not addressed any of your important questions, feel free to drop it in the comments box. We will ensure we get back with you with the best answer possible. Now, until then, this is Vishnu signing off. Happy learning.